here because the car broke down. But as you can see, our topic is, as technology gets better, is negatively affecting society, or in other words, to make it simpler, the negative effects technology has on us as a society. And as I'm sure everyone is aware, technology is everywhere nowadays, whether it's everyone has a phone, computer, television, no matter where you look, there's always some sort of technological device. And so, in today's day and age, we've become so dependent on it that it's actually ruining a lot of our social skills, especially one area is basic social communication. So I have a few questions, and I ask that if it applies to you, raise your hands. So how many of you have been hanging out with a group of friends, but instead of actually talking and looking at each other, everyone's been staring at their phone or computer?
Honestly?
Yeah, see, as you can see, almost basically everyone has been there. And yeah, you just don't communicate as well as you used to when you were younger, because technology is everywhere, and you just, yeah. And so the next question I have is, how many people have been trying to have a conversation with someone else, but instead of looking at you, they've just been looking down at your phone or their computer? As you can see, basically the same result. And that makes you feel terrible because you feel like they're not fully engaged and they just don't care about what you're trying to talk about. And so now out of those, everyone basically raised a hand, how many of those have actually been the ones on their devices? Yeah. So as you can see, the one major problem is technology. And technology gives us the urge to know what's going on at every single moment of our lives, no matter where we are or what's going on around us. And in a few moments, Mike and Katie will talk about the other aspects of our lives that it affects, but first I just want to share a quick study. It was done last year by Time Magazine, and it said 68% of tech users said that they brought their device to bed with them, and later they'll go into more depth of how that negatively affects everything that goes into your sleeping patterns and your mental health. And 20% of people say that they check their phone every 10 minutes, and you may not think that's a lot, but it's more than you would think. And 1/3 of everyone that was polled said that they felt anxious when separated from their devices, even for just short amounts of time. And it also says that regular late night computer use is associated with sleep disorders, stress, and even symptoms of depression. So as you can see just from that, technology is not good for us. And now Mike will talk more about how it affects our mental health.
So I'm going to start with technology. Technology advances, our mental health has gotten worse. We find ourselves constantly checking our phones for texts, calls, emails, and the news posts on social media. I understand there are some benefits to technology, being able to answer a question within minutes and having the ability to communicate with friends and family within seconds. However, there is stress by not, we always constantly check our phones for immediate response from a text, or checking our Instagrams for how many likes we get, which is affecting our mental health by having our lives be surrounded by technology and social media. I found three studies. My first study was done by Cindy Lauren's team. She found that too much screen time led to mental health problems, including depression, lack of sleep, and a change of moods. And my next study was done by Jed Foundation. Jed Foundation is a foundation that empowers teens and young adults with skills and support to grow into healthy and thriving adults. They took a poll that found that 90% of college students use social media sites, which can cause a cognitive defect. And then my next study was done by a researcher at Baylor University. She found that women college students spend up to 10 hours a day on their phones, while men spend up to 8 hours a day on their phones, which can have an effect on your sleep, mood swings, and can increase depression. And now I'll be passing on to Katie to talk about how technology affects your learning.
Okay, so we're gonna do another quick little poll. I want you all to raise your hand if you've ever been using your phone during class. Okay, now keep your hand up if you've ever been caught by your teacher or your professor. Okay, so as you can see, this is a large majority of us. So through my research, I found a teacher who had been teaching in the Lowell Public Schools for 20 years. Her name is Miriam Morgan Stern. And she found that technology has created an incredible distraction and made it much more difficult to teach. She also said that it's pretty hard to compete with a very funny YouTube video, Instagram post, or you name it, Facebook, whatever it is. Many people in Morgan Stern's field would agree that while there can be some benefits to technology, as Mike said. It's just a distraction that compromises students' learning and focus in the classroom. Students who are constantly asked to put their phone away by teachers or professors not only impact their own learning, but they impact the learning of everybody else around them and slow down the speed of the classroom. Technology's addictive tendencies have negatively impacted our learning, which has a negative impact on society as a whole. Going off of this, we don't pay attention anymore. Not only is our learning affected from our lack of attention, but our social life and our motor skills have been affected too. There have been many times, like as we said, when I'm with my friends and we're all bored, so we all go on our phones, or I walk into a room and I have no idea why I'm in that room anymore because the TV's on or I'm texting my friends. So a professor at Des Moines University surveyed 210 people between the ages of 18 to 65 to rate their behaviors in areas linked to perception, memory, and motor function. And he found that the more times a person used an internet or a mobile phone, the more likely they were to experience cognitive failures. He says, we are using technology daily, but we don't understand the effects that it's having on us. And I think that's true. Like, as technology grows, we really don't know everything that's happening to us in our brain function, or even just staring at a screen all day. Like, that's not a good thing for us. So our last point is that we don't understand tone anymore. We don't even understand how to write it. So a lot of us have received emails or texts that we don't completely understand the tone of. Some of us even send them and then think, wait, what? I didn't mean any of that in a negative way. It is really hard for us to know the tone of something that comes across electronically. The CEO and co-president of Manawa Networks did research and found that 90% of email recipients incorrectly believe they can interpret the tone of an email, and 50% of the time, individuals misinterpret the meaning of the tones in the emails. This can have a seriously negative impact on our interaction with people in our work, school, and social life. He gives us four main tips to properly use tone in electronic correspondence. One, you must not get too comfortable. Two, consider the words used. Three, do not use emoticons. And four, put yourself in the reader's shoes. He says, today's business professionals aren't following these tactics, but are communicating electronically as if they're texting a friend. By not following these tactics, an individual's message is at high risk of being misinterpreted. Because we don't know how to properly communicate tone through technology, it's negatively affecting our work, social, and school life, and the growing misinterpretation between people has just enforced how negative technology is on our society. So to share a little more of what Mike touched on, as you can see from this graph, phones play a big role in the quality of sleep we get. So this graph is showing us that almost 65% of people sleep with their phones either in their bed or next to them in bed. This has a serious impact on the quality and length of sleep we get, because as our phone buzzes, we wake up. Even if the light just goes off, we're not in a full, deep REM sleep that we should be for 6 to 8 hours a day. It shows that it's not until age 65 when some people start to disconnect with their phone while they're sleeping. Most people say that we do this for convenience. We never want to miss a text or a call, but this is having a negative impact on our health, because if we don't get an adequate amount of sleep, we can't function throughout the day, and all the things that we have discussed start to spiral. So this next visual was created by an occupational therapist, and it breaks down the impact of TV, cell phone, and internet use. These things are disrupting our physical and mental health. As you can see, it falls all the way down, so each of those three things, and then it goes from, it causes ADHD, autism, impulsiveness, all these things, addictive tendencies. As mentioned before, people who use mobile phone and internet most heavily are likely to make mistakes and be forgetful and have worse spatial awareness. Excessive use of tech can also cause feelings of isolation and neglect, which can contribute to depression. decrease technology's risk of insomnia and mental disorders and lack of attention and the misuse of tone, we say hang up and hang out. So some strategies that you can use to do this are leave your phone and go for a walk. Turn your phone off every time you walk into the classroom. Turn your phone off every time you're driving. Put your phone in the room next to you while you're sleeping. If you say you need an alarm clock, go buy one, you know? Now I'm going to hand it on to Ben, and he's going to finish up for us.
Thank you. Mike mentioned it, Katie mentioned it. There are positive effects to technology, right? It's a fact, we're not denying that. But what we're going to talk about is the negative effects it has on our society, right? So, because that is the problem. And like every problem, we have solutions to them. So, the main thing we have to do, the number one thing we have to do, is reduce the daily usage of our technology devices, right? So, reduce the daily usage of your phones. And I mean, I know for like people our age especially, that feels like it's impossible to do. Because now it almost feels like, you know, your phone is that like extra pill or something that you can't do without. But so that's why we have these action steps for you to follow. And just follow them like daily and see where that takes you. So the first thing you have to do is reduce your daily use of social media to like a couple times a day, right? So, Apple recently just confirmed that its device users unlock their phones at least 80 times every day, from like texting to checking an Instagram post to, I don't know, skipping a song from your playlist, checking your emails, things like that. So, approximately 80 times a day. I said we reduce that to like 60 times a day, you know? Just bring it down. The second thing we need to do is turn off your phone. I think Katie mentioned that. Turn off your phone from time to time when you're into class, when you're in church. Just like turn off your phone from time to time. So when your phone is off, you're not getting any texts, you're not replying to texts, you're not disturbing anyone, no one is disturbing you, right? You're able to concentrate more and be more productive. And the third thing you need to do is don't sleep with your phone next to you or within your reach. Now, I know a lot of us, like she said, a lot of us want to use this excuse of, oh, I use my phone for alarm clock, or my phone wakes me up. Please like get yourself an alarm clock or something. You know, it's easier. It's not going to harm you. It's not going to affect the sleep pattern, which a cellular phone can do. So like if your phone wakes you up in the morning, it may also be keeping you up at night. That's a quote I found somewhere. According to a post on Huffington Post, I think it was that the graph that was brought up earlier, nearly 3/4 of people from ages 18 to 44 sleep with their phones within their reach. So again, that's like most people in this graph, like that age bracket, like 18 to 44, we sleep with our phones either close to your bed or next to your pillow. You know, you want to text your girlfriend, your bed one more time before you go to bed, or you want to just like check that email one last time, or you want to like post a good night, whatever meme on Snapchat. So you know, people do that every time. I do it too, but that's like an habit we have to stop, right? So don't sleep with your phone next to you. Put it like, just maybe in the next room or something. So the constant urge to check your phone every minute or wake up to the sound of a text message is because you have your phone within your reach, right? So even when you're asleep, I don't know how many of us have heard, I felt like your phone is ringing or vibrating when it's like actually not. Like, yeah, that happens a lot, right? So that's something that's called phantom ringing or ringsiety. So it is related to over-involvement with one's cell phones. So, so please just don't sleep with your phones. The last step is to set a goal for yourself. Check a journal of your phone activity and review it at the end of the week to see how far you First of all, the only reason these steps that would make that or that recommended, the only reason they would not work is if we don't follow them, right? So if we do follow these steps gradually and just skip to them, we'll be able to live with less stress, be more attentive, be, like learn more actively and always know what people around us are saying or trying to say to us. Just we'll pay better attention, everybody's happy. Now, if it doesn't work, which means if we do not follow these steps, if we ignore them, then we continue to let technology control our lives, right? Everyone becomes, the robot takes over the world. No. But seriously, nothing will change for better, right? So we'll be more disconnected from our society, we'll become more boring, less sociable. Nobody wants that. So it is better for everyone to just follow these steps that we've recommended, and everybody's up. Yeah, that's all. Thank you.